Hi, very lovely afternoon to all of you. This is Bhavesh Kothari. I'm the co-founder and director of Billennium Divas. On the show today at Billennium Divas Show, we have a very, very dynamic woman entrepreneur. That's what I call her. Dr. B. Sai Ranjani. Welcome, Dr. Sai Ranjani, for the Billennium Divas Show.
Thank you.
Quick introduction, you know, that is the mandate that we normally have. So, Sai, as she's fondly called, is a passionate sustainability advocate, a finance professional, researcher in insurance domain. She's a Bharatanatyam performer as well, trained Carnatic vocal singer, mother of two, and the list goes on. So, let's welcome Sai to today's show. Sai, thank you so much for joining in. Quick introduction about Billennium Divas is we are a platform to nurture and encourage more women entrepreneurship and investments as well. But we are not limited to only entrepreneurship because we feel entrepreneurship is beyond just startup and business. I think it is more on how can we contribute to the society and the world at large and to humanity. So what are your thoughts on this?
Definitely. I mean, people look at entrepreneurship as a very narrow word. It's much more than just in terms of monetary benefit. If you take up a job and you're trying to do something independently over there, trying to create an impact, trying to do something different, that is entrepreneurship. If you're a housewife, you're trying to do something for the society, you may not have monetary benefit out of it, but the satisfaction that you get, the leadership that you display, that is entrepreneurship. And there is a lot that people can do. Wherever you are, whichever phase of life you are, there is lots that people can do. If you're a young child, you can do something. You're a grown-up, you can do something. You are an aged person, you can do something. You just need to have the bent of mind to get started.
Wow, fantastic. You are a sustainability advocate, right? What does this word sustainability mean? Is it CSR or is it beyond that?
I think CSR narrows it a lot. Sustainability is like the superset. It's much more than just CSR. Let's talk in an individual perspective. I mean, everyone, when you talk CSR, you look at large organizations and what people are doing at a company level. Let's talk at an individual level. What can you do towards sustainability? What is sustainability? Sustainability is to do things such that you're avoiding wastage, you're curtailing your resources, and you're utilizing it to the maximum so that the future generation can benefit. You yourself can benefit. How can you and I do that? Let's take lights, right? How many of us are guilty of it? We have the switch on, charger connected, nothing charging. Waste of electricity. Just takes 30 seconds to switch it off. We don't do it. A sustainable bent of mind would be switch off when you step out. My children don't do it. I'm guilty of that. My children don't do it. And you have to send them back inside and do it. Sometimes I don't do it. But it's a process. It's a process to make sure that you are constantly focusing on reducing waste. Food, the amount of food that's wasted in marriages. Wasted at home, ghar pe restaurant bana hua hai. Ek ko ek khana hai, dusre ko dusra khana hai. Why? Hamare zamane mein, our mothers used to say, this is food, eat it. Even today when my daughter asks me, what have you cooked for lunch or what do you cook for dinner? I say, food. So why don't you tell me what? I said, because whatever I have done, you have to eat. Finished. There is no hotel running over here. You have to eat. Cook just how much is needed. Don't waste. You have food, you have time. Sustainable utilization of time. Kitna time waste hota hai. The amount of time you and I waste on the phone. You have trackers, right? How much time have you spent on YouTube? How much time have you spent on Facebook? 5 hours a day, 6 hours a day. You don't realize it. Subconsciously, you're doing it. That is again things that you and I as individuals can do. And it's. I mean, I don't want to sound cliche, but people are right when they say phones have become an addiction. Even for the elderly people, right? You nana nani ke paas jao, to unke haath mein bhi phone rehta hai, kuch na kuch chal raha hota, isn't it? So sustainability has to be a way of thinking, a way of living. How you prevent waste? How you maximize the resources that you have? Some people ask me, you have 42 hours in a day. How do you manage to do everything? You know, you told dancing, music, singing, sustainability, classes, there's so many things. How do you do it? Sustainable use of time.
Wow. So, you mentioned a very, very critical point, right? Utilization of time. I think that's the most valuable resource. source everyone has,
yes.
and that's 24 hours,
yes.
right, with all of us. How can individuals utilize their skills and strengths and contribute to the society at large?
Sure.
Because I call this as an ISR, individual social responsibility.
Definitely.
Right? So, what are your thoughts on that?
So, there are things that you can do at an individual level. There are things that you can do at a community level. At an individual level, like I told you, wastage of time, food, money, energy. Money, how? 10 kurta hai. Meko Bombay jana hai. Buy another kurta. Need it? No. Cupboard is overflowing. Do you need it? No. But we do it. I have a wardrobe full of saris. Which, how many do I wear? It's a debatable question. So, all of us are guilty of that. I can see my friend here smiling because she relates to it. Right? So, you have excess. So, at an individual level would be to curtail that excess. To curtail that desire of overdoing it. To do more than what, to buy more than what is required. I'll just give you an example. I once got stuck in the rain. Right outside a shop which was selling umbrellas. So I told my son, let me just quickly buy an umbrella and we'll go home. My son tells me, Mama, we have 3 umbrellas at home. Just because it is raining now and we don't have an umbrella does not mean we need a 4th umbrella. Let's just wait for 5 minutes, it will stop raining.
Wow.
I had to listen to him. I said, fine, I'll wait. We waited for the rain to stop and we left. So every purchase decision, if you think about the impact that you're doing, that is sustainability at an individual level. Then at a community level, we live in a society. If you want to be happy, you cannot be happy if the person next to you is unhappy.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So your empowerment will happen only when people around you are empowered. So how do you inculcate that? How do you do that? You can have distribution drives. Once a week, or what we do in my society is we encourage the children because they are the future and we need to inculcate the thought in them. We tell them to set aside a fistful of rice in a separate container every day. And at the end of the month, every first Sunday of the month, we cook food using that rice which is set aside.
That's amazing.
And we include the child in that cooking process. Ki dekho, tumne hata ke rakha, tumne nikal ke rakha. Is chawal ka hum bana rahe. And they are taking part in the packing. So every month we have almost 60 to 70 food packets that are cooked on the first Sunday of the month. And we have a volunteer who comes and distributes it to the slum. We are not getting rid of poverty, but we are making sure somebody has got a meal, a proper meal, jo shraddha ke saath banaya hai. It's not, you're not doing it for the sake of doing it.
Right.
And the child is also involved, so they also get a sense of giving. So that sense of giving has to come. So at a society level, you can organize drives like that. What you need to do, what is most important is to have a little bit of leadership. If somebody takes the step forward, everyone else will join in to support. Sai, we shall do today. Sai, we shall do. So this Sunday, I'm here. This is the first Sunday of the month and I'm in Bombay. So I have my regular contributors pinging me on the side saying, Sai, first Sunday is coming. Because they are keeping track of it. They are keen to do it. And I'm like, this month we'll do it on second Sunday. So they're like, fine, as long as we're doing it. So that sense of giving back to the community has to happen. Then what we do again is once in 3 months, once in 4 months, we organize, you can call it decluttering drives. We have so much at home. Our houses are bursting in seams. Whatever you're not using, past 6 months you've not used, take it out, donate it. We set up a library in a government school with the items, the books that were donated. And the children are benefiting out of it.
Fantastic.
Right? You just need to take the drive. You just need to take the first step and automatically you will find. It's like a magnet, isn't it? When you're doing something positive, it will automatically attract other people who have the same thinking, the same mentality, and automatically the universe will collude with you.
True.
Yeah, you're all entrepreneurs. You're all trying to be entrepreneurs. You just have to take the first step. And once you take the first step, the entire universe will collude with you to take you in the same direction.
Fantastic. I think it's a great thought. I think contribution coming in smaller drops can lead to an ocean as well, right? You mentioned a very, very crucial point about community.
Yeah.
And you know, we are a women entrepreneurs,
yes.
community. We have been actively supporting women entrepreneurs in their entrepreneurial venture and all that, right? Now, a question comes to my mind, right? And this is again, you know, aligning with sustainability thought process. creating a more cohesive ecosystem for communities and for their enterprises, how can they inculcate this habit of sustainability as well? Because a lot of what you say really, really makes sense. Entrepreneurship is, as you already said, is not just about making money. It's not about creating an enterprise. It's beyond that.
Mm-hmm.
So, what are your thoughts on this?
When you have this sustainable bent of mind, you will see opportunities everywhere. I'll give you an example. I was staying in Calcutta. So, in my complex, there was a basti close by from where the servants used to come, and the servants used to always complain, "Aaj tabiyat theek nahi hai, aaj tabiyat theek nahi hai, aaj nahi aa raha tabiyat theek nahi hai." So, when this tabiyat theek nahi hai, is happening a lot. So, we one day decided to walk across to the basti, and we saw that people are genuinely falling sick. So, what we did was, again, three or four ladies got together. Now, the thing that worked for us was, we had a hospital close by. So, a lot of doctors were staying in our complex. So, we reached out to the doctors, literally door to door, knocking at the doctor's door, saying, "Look, we want to conduct a medical camp for the villagers over here. Can you help? You will have to come give your time to us, and that's all you need to do." So, the doctors agreed. So, we had three or four doctors who came, and we used to conduct a medical camp every week. We are all housewives. Yeah? We all have our jeb kharcha. We put it all together. We bought generic medicines. Cold, cough, fever, diarrhea. Generic medicines. So when the doctor comes, he will see all the medicines that are there. And then he will see, okay, fine. So when the patient comes, what do you have in slums? You have health, skin care related issues, or health, fever, or cold, or cough. Those are the kind of ailments that you normally have. If it is something bigger, then you will have to go to a doctor and show it. You have to get tests done, etc. So we used to run the medical camp. And the frequency of "Didi tabiyat theek nahi hai" reduced. Why? Because along with the camp, you were also telling them basic hygiene.
True.
You keep your haath munh bum, like how we say it in Lifebuoy. Haath munh bum. You keep the three of them clean. That's enough. Half your problems are solved.
True.
So every time you will see an opportunity. And when you see that opportunity, don't hesitate. Just go ahead and take it. What's the worst that can happen? Nahi hoga. Theek hai. Pehle bhi nahi ho raha tha. Big deal. Right? Just go ahead. Do it. You have nothing to lose. And that should be your attitude. I have nothing to lose. I came to Bombay today to meet few people. Did I come as part of my job? Not really. I came because I wanted to build a network. And I felt that if I came, I will have more impact as against connecting virtually. And it did happen. The objectives with which I came, I'm able to do that and much more because I physically came. So, you just have to take the first step and automatically things will fall in place. I think the biggest thing that we women do is we hesitate. Saas kya bolegi, sasur kya bolega, pati kya bolenge, bacche kya bolenge. I mean, we are so used to thinking ki hamara pura sansaar kya bolega. Then, hum kya chahte hai, we forget it. Don't do that. Aap bhi insaan ho. You have your dreams, you have your goals. Work towards it. There's nobody who's stopping you from doing it. The biggest enemy of your dreams is you yourself.
Very true.
Take that first step and you can do. Sky's the limit. That first step, if you take, you're done.
Absolutely. I think it's sending goosebumps into me as well. I think it's very, very true, right? I think as entrepreneurs or as individuals, I think we are the limitations of our own self, right? If we don't try, we will never be able to understand our true potential.
Yeah.
Right? I think it's a very interesting conversation, and I'm very happy that you've been able to come here and talk to us as well. One thought that I wanted, from you as an individual, right? So, from an entrepreneur perspective, right? Anything that you feel that we as a society still lack and can contribute to make this a much better space for maybe our future generation?
I think the problem is we don't ask enough, right? We hesitate to ask. Ask for help. You need something, ask for help. You will be surprised at the number of people who are actually willing to help.
True.
We hesitate. Are kya sochega? Kya samjhega? No. Again, you have nothing to lose. You yourself have built that mindset ki shayad no bolega or it may not work out. No, don't have that mindset. Don't pull yourself back. society, we are at a space where women working is respected, women trying to do something for themselves is respected, women staying at home taking care of family is respected, women trying to do something apart from family is also, everything is respected. We are in a space where if you want to do something, you can do it.
True.
Right? So as a society, I feel that inclusivity has increased. What we need to do is go ahead. What we fear is failure.
Yes.
That is not easy. You don't have things coming to you on a platter. And I love to give this example. So with your permission, I'd like to give an example. I did my doctorate in economics from XLRI Jamshedpur. I started doing that. This itself is a journey. I started when my son was 2.5 years old. I finished when my daughter was 2.5 years old. So everyone is like, do bachchon ke saath doctorate ki, wo bhi XLRI se kiya. So one of the things that I learned in that journey was perseverance. Bachcha hai, chota bachcha hai, 2.5 years old bachcha hai. I lost my mother during that journey. My daughter was born. We relocated between cities. Lots happening in life. But still, I did it. Obviously, I couldn't do it by myself. I'd be lying if I didn't have family support. I couldn't have done it without. I mean, I have an assignment submission. My husband will pack off my children and say, chalo bahar niklo. And I have the house for myself to study. You know, you need that kind of support. But along with that, you also have that perseverance that, okay, I had this paper and I did it once and I was very happy with it. Ah, maine dhoda la, ekdam super work. And I gave it to my professor. He's like, very nice, Sai, but why don't you do this? And it's back to the drawing board. And again, I'm doing it. I'm again thinking, ah, dhoda la, this is better than the first version. And I go back and give it to him and he's like, very nice, Sai, why don't you do this? 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 16 times.
Wow.
16 times. I kid you not. 16 times I did that paper again. Version 1 and version 16 is completely different. It's completely different. But have I finished that paper? I haven't.
Oh, not yet.
I haven't. My professor, I finished my doctorate 2 years back. Oh, I completed. I'm Dr. Sai Ranjani. When I finished my whenever my professor calls me, even now, he'll tell me, Sai, do you want to pick up that paper? Why don't you do your postdoctorate with it? I said, I'll definitely pick up that paper, but I don't think I'm picking up postdoctorate right now because there's so many things that I'm doing. I want to do justice to it, so I'll not pick that up right now. But what I'm saying is, in that process, I learned to accept. Every time sir used to say, Sai, why don't you do this? I was in tears because the amount of effort that is needed to rework it. I mean, I had 10 years of data across 32 countries that I had to rework.
Wow.
10 years of data. And Excel sheet mein baithi, you're crunching through the numbers and you're trying to analyze the numbers and come to a conclusion. You've done that 16 times. And still your professor says...
That's a huge effort in itself.
It is a huge... Every time I used to be at the verge of tears saying, God,
wow.
I can't do this. And I was like, nahin, karna hai, karna hai. And I tell the story with regards to that also. Gosh, once you get me started, I'll have lots to share.
I'm loving this.
So, karna hai, karna hai, karna hai, karke kiya. Even though that paper didn't complete, in that process I learned. I learned to say, fine, something positive is coming out of it. Something positive is coming out of it. In the end, that one paper branched out into 3 papers, which eventually formed part of my doctorate. That base paper is still there. But the thought process that took place, it led to a logical conclusion.
Wow.
Yeah?
Fantastic.
And you always need somebody to motivate you.
True.
Right? So, sabse bada danda mere ko kahan se mila pata hai? My son.
Wow. How is
he? I was scolding him. You know how mothers are. Homework nahi kiya, padhai nahi ki. I'm sure you relate to that. Homework nahi kiya, padhai nahi ki. And my son stops. He's coming back home. You haven't finished your homework. How can you tell me to do my homework? I stopped at my feet. And like, I mean, I had logical excuses, reasonable excuses. I lost my mother. I have a newborn baby. I have reasons to take a break. My professor said, when you've not done your homework, how can you expect me to do? You have to practice what you preach.
100%.
And I said, nothing doing, and I have to finish it. And I finished it and showed it to my son, the first person, saying, look, I've done it.
Fantastic. So I think it's a great space that you have been operating, and this is, I think, out of your passion that you've been doing, because I believe what I see is you are a finance professional, as well. And what you say is very right. I quote this at a lot of spaces where I speak. Right, it is not about women empowerment. I think it's a very wrong word to use. Women don't need empowerment, is what I firmly believe. What we need is, to support them.
Yes.
Support coming in from family.
Yes, definitely.
Support coming from the society.
Yes.
I think this is a great example of why we talk about this as empowerment.
Mm.
I think empowerment is within.
Yes.
We limit our own self.
Exactly.
Right? As much as I would want to keep, continuing this, I want one last parting note from you for all of our women entrepreneurs who are going to be listening to this amazing talk that we have. And then I promise you, I will definitely get back, Sai, once again to our show to make sure that we dig deeper into her, graces, and understand more on different aspects of her personal front as well as CSR, ISR, or maybe sustainability per se.
Sure.
Right? What is one message that you would want to give out to those women who have either limited themselves or they are either struggling to understand where do they move, and to women who are entrepreneurs, and trying to create a difference? One small message that you feel can really, really make them think and jump out of their chairs and say, hey, look, this is something I can do it.
Sure. I think there are a few things that all of us, and not restricted to women, even men, need to have. One is patience. Things will happen when they're supposed to happen. You have to persevere. The second P, patience, perseverance. You have to work hard. You have to work hard. Keep striving at it. And don't hesitate. It will come when the time is right. Sometimes you give up just before the last step. Just before the last step. Put in patience. Put in perseverance. Third is prioritize. Know what you want. I think the biggest mistake we women do is we don't know what we want. Ye mere pati ko chahiye, ye mere saas ko chahiye, mere sasur ko chahiye, mujhe kya chahiye? In our responsibilities, in our roles that we have as a mother, as a sister, as a wife, as a sister-in-law, as a daughter-in-law, I as an individual gets lost. And we have to take out at least 10-15 minutes to think about what do you want.
True.
Only when you have a clarity of what you want, can you get what you want. Jab khud hi nahi pata kya chahiye, samne wala dega kya? How can the society help you when you yourself don't know what you want? So be clear, have the clarity of vision, work towards it, and the universe will collude to work with you.
Fantastic. I think this is a great thought. And I think, as she rightly said, I think we need to know ourselves, we need to spend time with ourselves, and we need to adjust it with ourselves, I think. And entrepreneurship being a lonely journey, I think it starts with I.
Yes.
As she rightly said, if I don't do it, or if I don't take care of myself, how am I going to be able to fulfill the dreams that I have or the contribution that I want to do? I think, thank you so much, Sai. I think, on behalf of Billennium Divas and all our divas, I would definitely thank you so much for joining us today and spending your time, valuable time. More important is, the mission that we are and the support that you gave to this. I think it's phenomenal. So thank you so much from
thank
the bottom of my heart.
Thank you.
And I look forward to again engaging with you
definitely
in the future.
Definitely.
Thank you so much. So keep watching Billennium Divas Show with more women entrepreneurs coming and giving you their wisdom